All right, today's video that I'm going to share with you is going to be about how I succeeded overcoming incredible hardships, how I overcame problems, whether it was financial, whether I was, you know, I had zero money and I had to make from zero, or I had a nearly impossible task to achieve success, like coming back to Dubai when I was penniless. You know, it can be anything, or it can even be like the problem I have in my house, the hoarding issue which I'm trying to sort out. And this is how I got the idea for the topic. Now, before I share this video, I'll be putting timestamps below. But before I share this topic, my request to you is, you know, first when you listen to it at 2x speed or whatever, but make it a point to take down notes, okay? If you're not going to take down notes, it doesn't help. And the second thing is, after taking down notes, don't just take notes and keep it somewhere. Like, you know, so many people go for seminars, so many people go for events. They get this file, they get this folder. They're very happy. And then they take it and put it on a bookshelf somewhere and it's catching dust. I mean, why are you doing this? You're just living in an illusive, like a kind of an illusion where you believe, oh, I'm improving, but you're not actually improving. You're just collecting knowledge. Like, people who read Wikipedia doesn't make them smart. So please don't be one of those people who listens to podcast after podcast, MP3 after MP3, watches videos after videos, read books after books, but doesn't put into practice. Better than that, learn one skill, master the one skill, and improve your life. Like I tell people, reading about karate is not going to make you a karate expert. Okay, reading about a recipe and not doing anything about it will not make you a good cook. So in the same way, please take down notes and understand this much. Look, I know that you have a habit of, oh, Loy, share this video for free. I charge people for my time. So you think that, you know, this what I'm giving you is what I share with my clients on a paid basis, okay? And remember this much, just having the knowledge is not enough. Application of knowledge is important. So you can know about, if I do 50 push-ups, my chest, you know, and my shoulders will become stronger. Fine. But you can't do even 5. What the fuck are you talking about 50 push-ups, man? Do it and fucking show, no? All right. So let's get on with it. So these are the 21 points that have helped me overcome, you know, any kind of problem or any kind of challenge. So let's begin with the first one. The first one, the most fundamental one that I'll tell you is, you need to have the mindset and the character. Now, why I'm starting this with the first one is, if you don't have the character, if you don't have the mindset, if you don't have the competence, if you don't have the fire that is within you and it's not consistent, it's no point here. Like, you need to ask yourself, have you any time in your life been obsessed about something, been focused about something? It could be a game, it could be a girl, it could be a sport or whatever. If you have put your heart and soul day and night to complete that task or to take part in whatever it is that interests you, if you have that, fine. But if you're one of those people who just likes to sit on a fucking couch and, you know, eat fries and popcorn and comment on others, hey, what the fuck, yeah, you should have hit a fucking six, or you should have scored a goal, you know, fucking hit him, man, in boxing you're looking, and then shut the fuck up, man. Yeah, I'll tell you, I'm a person who tells people, not all people are created equal, not everyone's the same, you either have it or you don't. And this bullshit that people give you, that everyone's born equal, that's fucking rubbish. There are some people who are born like fucking assholes. There are some people whose character is totally messed up. You just can't change them. There are some people, it's too late, man. You know, so either you have it or you don't. Okay, that's point number one. Point number two is obsession. Okay, now let me tell you something surprising. You know this video that I'm making? Okay, there are a lot of things which you do not know. This is the third time I'm making this video. Can you believe this? Third time. The first time I started making this video, I started from my house here. I went all the way till there, and then there was this car that was playing the fucking music. And the problem is, if you have music at the background, which is copyrighted, the video goes silent. And then I will lose a segment of my video, and then it doesn't make any sense. Okay, so I switched it, you know, 14 minutes went away. I had to redo it. And when you try to redo after getting into a flow, it's very hard. I tried to do it again. I was struggling, stuttering, sputtering, and it's like, ah, okay. Then I tried the third time. So now I think it's a fourth time that I'm bloody doing this video, man. And you might think, ah, so what's the big deal? Try talking for 40 minutes, non-stop, 40 minutes, and then losing out all that content and starting all over again. Having to put that energy. See, now you can hear my dog screaming and shouting in the background. You can hear that? Yeah. That also can be fucking distracting. But I need to keep my focus. I need to keep the enthusiasm. I need to keep that fervor when communicating the message, you know? So, you know, people don't understand. You try talking for 40 minutes with full enthusiasm, gusto and focus. You'll find out how difficult it is. It's not easy. So what I'm telling you is, the second point is obsession. Now, when I'm obsessed about something, man, I'm fucking crazy. I will, you know, like, I'll give you an example. Now, you know that I'm doing the mess in my house, okay, sorting it out. Do you know that every day, as soon as I get up, I immediately go to the kitchen, I check the mess, and I'm standing there. I'm actually standing there, I'm looking. Okay, I kept this there, okay. This has to be kept there. Then I'm cleaning it. Then I'm removing this. Then I'm planning. Okay, this has to be moved. Immediately upon getting up, after keeping my bed, I just go to the kitchen. I'm standing there for 15-20 minutes. Then I make my black coffee espresso. I'm sipping. And I'm still planning it out. I'm still thinking. And I stand there for 1 hour, literally, planning, okay, things are going to be done this way. Then I go through the whole day. And then in the night, before sleeping, again, I stand in the same place. I'm like, okay, what the fuck do I have to do? You know, I'm so exhausted by the time night comes. I'm so exhausted. I just crash. By the way, let me confess something, which will absolutely not only shock you, it'll kind of disgust you. Oh, by the way, look, a snake, two snakes. One snake is here. This one is smashed. The other snake looks like a fresh snake. I don't know what the fuck is this. You can see? It's a snake. Okay, two snakes. Okay, anyway. So what was I telling you is... okay, this confession that I'm going to give you, which will be disgusting. Do you know that... you can see, no? Do you know that this is the second day I've not had a shower? I know I hate to say this, but this is after doing exercise. When I come back home, I'm supposed to have a shower. But after I came back home, I stand there, and then again I'm looking at a task. And again I'm looking at something else. And then something else comes up. And then I need to fix this. Then the repairman comes. Then the other guy calls me. And by the time I know it, I'm so fucking involved in the task. Then I, oh shit, if I go now, I can go buy something before the store closes. It's so fucking crazy, man. Trust me, I know it sounds disgusting when you say, oh, I didn't even have time for a bath. But it is so maddening. By the time I step back, I'm so exhausted. I just crash. Sometimes I have to even remind myself to have food. The only time I remember to have food is when my head starts turning because my sugar levels are low. So the second point is obsession. If you're not obsessed about something day and night, you're not thinking about it, you're not sleeping or dreaming about it, if you don't get up and again be involved in it, you cannot succeed, man. I'll tell you, I will show you the house after I finish all the mess, everything else. You'll be like, oh, okay, good job. Because there's so many things that I'm thinking about. Okay, so that's the second point, obsession. Point number three, I can't live without this, and it's coffee. See, everyone has their way of getting in the peak. Some people have exercise, some people, yes, I do exercise, which I'll speak out later. But coffee for me is very important. After I get up, the first thing that I do is black espresso without sugar, without cream, just black espresso. And I'll tell you, that kind of raises my heart rate and kind of makes me ultra focused, kind of fucking pissed off and angry. And it's not good. It affects my mood swings very badly. It makes me very aggressive. But that kind of forces me to work with a sense of urgency and importance. So, point number three is coffee. I don't know what is your stimulant, but I would recommend staying away from sweeteners, like stuff that has sugar in it, like Red Bull. Tea or coffee? For me, I'm more of a coffee guy, and especially very strong black espresso. But mind you, your heart rate will go up, so be careful of that. Point number four. Without this, I'll find things very hard. See, I'm a guy who thinks very fast. I have ADHD. I literally think like, I don't know, like they say 10,000 thoughts per minute. So my mind is constantly working. Okay, what is this? What is that? And it repeats. And sometimes it drives me mad. So one of the ways I found out to help me focus and get clarity is having a notepad. I have a dedicated notebook, a small notebook. It's not a very big one. And it has a pen. You know, it has a pen where you can keep it at the side, a small pen holder. So I keep a pencil there. So what I do is every time I get a thought, I take it out and I scribble. Every time I get an idea, I scribble. Every time, okay, I have to buy this, I write it down. The beauty of doing this is then that voice doesn't keep repeating itself. You don't get the same thing saying again, 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 again. It drives you mad otherwise, man, fuck. So for me, having a notepad or a notebook with a pen or a pencil is very important. And I'm not a very big fan of having a smart device and writing it. There's a, I don't know, there is a beauty in being able to write it down. Even though I'm telling you, my handwriting is so bad, I can't understand what I've written. But it forces you to think. So better than texting is writing it down or, you know, just typing stuff. So I write down on my notepad my thoughts and, you know, I scribble on it. So it's pretty good. Point number five is prioritization. I'm sure you heard this, but I'll tell you, it's not as easy as it sounds. And especially if you're not a student, but if you're a working class professional, prioritization is very tough. I'll give you an example. Let's say I want to clean my house. Okay. I want to clean the house and I want to keep things in order. A client will call me. I can't say no to a client. Someone will want to pay me money. Can't say no to it. A client who has paid me money will say, listen, I have a doubt. Your wife will call you. Your child wants something. There's some emergency. You know, so many things can happen during the day. If you're a student, you don't have to fucking bother. But if you're a working class professional, there are 110 things that can happen. Electricity can shut off. Yesterday I was working and my inverter, fucking, I don't know what the fuck happened to it. It just blew off. The electrician who was supposed to come changed his mind. The carpenter was there. He didn't bring his tools. The other guy who was supposed to fix things, his drill bit was not working. I told him, okay, gun, fuck this, let's go buy. I went and purchased for him equipment. And I told him, just keep it. So, you know, there are 110 things that come. But you need to prioritize and you need to do it fast. And time is of essence. You don't have all the time in the world. So you need to, I'll tell you, with your notebook, prioritize. Okay, this is important, that is important, this is what I need to do fast. And finish a task quickly, man. Don't fucking drag it. Which point is this? Point number six. I've written my notes because there are so many points. Point number six is doing one thing at a time. I know, you'll be like, eh, is that even a point? We live in a day and age where multitasking is given so much of importance. Wow, multitasking. I'm a multitasker. That's fuck all, man. You cannot achieve exceptional, you cannot achieve excellence in terms of work, in terms of delivery, if you multitask. How can you, do you know that the human mind can only think one thing at a time? How can you write an all-important email and cook food and talk to someone and dance? I know you've seen some of my videos where I'm listening to music and I'm typing and I'm playing a game. But those are not critical tasks. When I'm doing a critical task, when I'm doing something that is so important, everything is switched off. Music is off. My wife doesn't disturb me. Baby doesn't make noise. There's no game that is on. Like, best example, when I'm speaking to a client or customer, fuck, my 100% attention is on the customer. That's it. There's nothing more important than that. Like, even now when I'm doing the housework, that's it. I don't even put music sometimes. Now when I'm making this video, I'm not doing anything else, only this. So you need to do only that one task. Do one thing at a time and do it very well. Don't fucking talk about this or multitasking, multi-run bullshit. So fuck all, man. Point number 7, shut out all the noise. Now by noise, I'm not talking of listening to music, and by shutting out all the noise is, I'm talking of social media. I'm talking of the WhatsApp notifications, the email pop-ups, the people passing by. You know, sometimes when my wife and my baby is there, I want to be in my room all alone, but then there's some noise or another. I get so pissed off. You know what I do? I go to a coffee shop. May not be a sophisticated one, maybe somewhere where nobody comes. And I go sit there in a lone corner, or I go to a place where there is nobody. Sometimes in a coffee shop, I even pay the guy a little bit extra money and tell him, just keep it quiet, don't put music. The person gladly takes the money and gives me the silence. Sometimes I know this might sound crazy, I book a hotel room, which is very quiet. You know, you can literally hear the sound of the air. It's like soundproof. I go there so that I can think. So it's very important to have this, you know, you need to shut out all the noise. And when you're there, don't have your smartphone, don't have the internet, don't have anything. Just sit and focus. So for me right now in the house, my wife is not there, baby's not there, nobody's there. I just sit and do my work. So you need to shut out the noise. And the noise is distraction from the internet world and the outside people. Point number 8, like I told you, music, switching it off. I don't know why, but when you have silence, no? You can really think. Some people like to put this calm music at the background, and I'm not a very big fan of that. I believe in total silence. See, we talk about calm music at the background. We talk about these apps for productivity. What about the olden days when there was no apps, when there's no smartphone, no internet, when people had to focus and they just keep silent, right? So you need to focus. Even when, you know, some people have their videos, they have music at the background. I was like, how the fuck can you listen to what they are talking with this stupid, shitty music at the background? So silence, I'll tell you, silence is very important. That is why if you sit in a room and you meditate, you know, you gain clarity like no one else is busy. Even when you study, try silence. It's uncomfortable in the beginning, but eventually you learn that silence is your best friend. And you're listening this from a guy who's ADHD, who's hyper. I'm telling you, silence works wonders. Then point number 9. Now point number 9 is being where the action is, or being where the problem is. You know, in many parts of the world, especially like Dubai and all that, you'll always have this white manager, this Gora guy, or this local Emirati who on a Thursday, say Thursday, Friday, he is on a beach somewhere with his family, enjoying, relaxing, and saying, hey man, you know, I hope you're doing the problem pretty well. I trust you. Ramu, do a great job. And they're lying on the beach and relaxing. No, that's not a true leader. A true leader is one who does not delegate. He's there where the problem is. He is with the problem. He doesn't leave. Like for example, Elon Musk. Elon Musk literally sleeps, eats, lives in his factory. Now, that's not healthy. But who said about being making a healthy lifestyle to achieve greatness? You cannot have a balanced life. You have to be obsessed. For me, I am literally, you know, like for example, now when I'm cleaning the kitchen or when I'm cleaning the living room, I literally take my bed and sometimes I sleep there. I sleep there, I wake up and I can see the problem. Okay, this is not in place, this is dirty, this is in a mess. Then, you know, I stand there. I look at it. Okay, I keep things in place. Then I go, when I come back again I'm there. So it's like I'm where the problem is. And if you are that kind of a person who does not run away from a problem, doesn't delegate, but is there, only then you can solve it. You know, the number of times I've gone to the kitchen, stood there, just stood there, sipping a coffee, no sugar, and looking at, okay, this has to be here, there. Then I go back, okay, talk to my client. Again, I come back in the kitchen, I'm standing there. Sometimes I take a chair, I sit there. Sometimes I'm taking my lunch break, I'm taking it there. So I don't go anywhere else. So you need to be where the problem is. And the reason for this is when you're where the problem is, then you figure out a way to solve it. So be uncomfortable, be where the problem is, and I'll tell you, you'll be able to solve it. Point number 10. People don't think about this, but it's important. It's your health. See, you know, we live in a culture where work 24/7, you know, you're so busy. Now, it's good to be busy. It's good to be focused. It's good to work 24/7, whatever. But if you're not healthy or you're hospitalized, finished, right? See, there are so many people who work to the point where their health shuts down. If you get a heart attack, if you get a blood clot, if you get a paralysis, half your body is paralyzed. Finished, right? How many people you must have known, or even I know personally, who had their lives cut short because they were workaholics? Why do you think I get up in the morning and first thing I do, exercise? Because I know work never ends. Fuck. Work just never ends. There's always something or another. There's always a new challenge. There's always a new issue. There's always a new problem. So I'm like, okay, clients will never end. Problems will never end. Okay, what I'll do? Let me finish my exercise first thing. So I finish my exercise. Looks like it's going to rain. So you can see. Looks like it's going to rain. So what I do is, I start off the day with exercise. I start off the day with finish my video recording. And then I, you know, do the other things. Others you cannot, yeah. So remember, health is very important. And if you don't keep yourself healthy, you get fucked. And I think I realized this the hard way when I started bleeding internally. And I lost so much of blood to the point where I was pale white. And if I would just walk 5 steps, I would be like, become like white, you know, and get dizzy because I was losing so much of blood. And then, you know, I nearly had diabetes, blood pressure. I went through the operation. So many changes in terms of my health and lifestyle. If you don't focus on your health, you're finished. So the next point, which people tend to take granted, is focus on your health and every day do something that helps you in terms of health, whether it's supplements, whether it's exercise, whether whatever, or sleep or whatever. Point number 11. Now, when you tell people about health, the first thing they think about is exercise. Now, why people don't want to do exercise? Because when you talk of exercise, you're talking of 1 hour, 1.5 hour. Now, for me also, my current problem that I have, I not only have work to do, I not only have my clients, I not only have to do my marketing, I not only have to do content creation, video editing, I also have my personal goals. And on top of that, I have to sort out this house, this issue, which is driving me mad. So how do you How do you put in exercise? You have only 24 hours a day, right? So the solution to this is short, intense workouts where your heart rate goes up. It can be, people normally, when they think of exercise, slow exercise for 1 hour, which I normally do. 1 hour exercise of slow running followed by this video sessions of 1 hour. But today, for example, what I've done is, today was a short exercise. So the short intense exercise is 15 minutes all out. So first you do the warm up. I'll speak to you more about this later, but please take some guidance. Don't try to do it all by yourself. You can get injured. It's very dangerous, huh? Especially for the joints and the heart. So be careful. So to give you in a nutshell, if my long exercise or the normal exercise is 1 hour slow running, the short exercise is after warm up and stretching, I start running slowly, then I build up the pace, then I build up more speed, then it goes more faster, then it goes more faster, then more faster, and then I slow down again. Then I go back. Again I start. Slow, little faster, little faster, little faster, little faster. And I'll tell you, in less than 5 minutes, I'm huffing and puffing. In few more minutes, 3 to 4 minutes, I'm already sweating. And another few more minutes, I'm like, literally, it's like, oh. And then, so it's like, instead of running slowly, you're running at, for example, when I run slow, I'm running at 20 to 30% of my capacity. When I'm doing hardcore exercise, I'm doing it at 70, double, or doing it at 80. But don't push it to 100, because then you can get injured. So in 15 minutes, less than 15 minutes, I'm huffing and puffing so badly, I can't think of doing another session. So always remember, high intensity exercise is a key. You can Google search and find out more information. It's like, instead of doing 10 push-ups relaxingly, do push-ups until you can't do a single one and you collapse. But be careful, because you might get a cramp. Huh? So this is another way of doing short intense exercise. So instead of 1 hour, I focus, due to time constraints, you know, 10 to 15 minutes, and that's it. Point number 12 is something we do every day, but we don't do it properly, and that's breathing. The breathing method that I follow is Wim Hof, W-I-N-H-O-F. Wim Hof, where he breathes in deep through the mouth and he exhales. Breathes in deep, like, I'll give you a demo. This is how I do it. This is me at least, okay? I do. I'm doing it with my mouth, okay? Breathe out. Now again. Breathe out. So I exhale deep as much as I can. I breathe, breathe. Because remember, when you are in the hospital, or you have had an injury, what do? They give you an oxygen mask, because oxygen is the most important. So I breathe in deep, 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 really deep, and exhale. Breathe in deep, 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 and exhale. And some people believe exhale until your lungs are completely empty. Now, it's up to you how you feel, but breathing in is more important. One caution I'll give you is, if you do it for the first time and you've never done it, you'll be really dizzy. Your head will turn. The reason for this is, your body is not accustomed to having plenty of oxygen. That means you're not breathing properly. So I would suggest, breathe in deep as much as you can. And you know, when I started off, I could do only 3 to 4 deep breaths. Today I can do up to 15 minutes. Okay, it's no point going too long. So every day, if you can do at least 10 deep breaths, I think that will help you a lot. Okay, so breathing. Next one, point number 13, is taking naps. You know, short naps, it can be 10 minutes, it can be 5 minutes, but don't go too long. Don't go like half an hour and all that. So the point of taking naps is to reset your system. Some people believe in meditation, some people believe in stillness. I just put the mat, I lie down, I keep a soft alarm to wake me up, Don't make it like jarring. It's like a slow crescendo build up. Wake me up after 10 to 15 minutes. So 5 to 15 minutes, multiple naps throughout the day will really help you recharge your system. It helps you reset your thinking. And sometimes when I get overwhelmed with too many problems and I can't think, this taking a nap really helps me. Then point number 14. See, one is taking naps, which helps you reset your system. Another one is, if you're looking at a problem and you're constantly looking at it, you'll not be able to gain clarity. Okay? One of the, you know, for example, if you go to a store and you're trying different perfumes, you know, after smelling two or three perfumes which you put on your skin, your nose gets numb with this smell. So what does the person who is giving you the testers, he tells you to smell coffee. So when you smell coffee, it changes it resets the smell again. So you get, okay, back to normal. So then you smell something else. So in the same way, when you're looking at a problem 24/7, you will not gain clarity unless you remove your mind out of that. So what I do is, I either go for a walk or I switch on my, you know, one of these free games. When you sign in, you get some bonus or you have a task. My favorite game is Funky Bay. I play Funky Bay. It's a kind of a farming game. So I just look at it for some time. I play two or three tasks. I complete and then I lose all my energy. And then I know I have to come back after another 1 hour. So this short break resets your system. However, one thing I will caution you, don't reset by going onto WhatsApp or chatting, or because if you get into that, they just pull you into a totally different world and that fucks up your head. So avoid checking emails or WhatsApp, and it takes you in a different dimension. And I feel it more counterproductive than productive. Then point number 15 is hire a professional. Now, you know, when I have problems, the tendency is, okay, I'll do everything by myself. But what I tend to do is I hire a professional. And not just any professional, not the one that I can bargain the price. I get the best. Like, for example, this I learned the tough way. When I got an electrician to do the work, he did some shoddy, bad job and it fucked up everything. Then I had to call another guy. He also made it a little good. It was good for 1 week. And then I had problems again. So finally, I ended up calling the actual professionals who do home improvement stuff. They cost me quite a lot, but they did the work really well. They did so well. You know, it has been almost a year. I don't have any problems with my electrical connection. And ever since, I call only those people. So what I suggest is stop being a miser. Go get yourself a professional. So whether it's your resume rebrand, whether it is, you know, fitness, whether it is learning a new skill, hire the top professionals in your industry. But make sure that these are not internet marketers who market themselves as professionals. Go to someone who has references, recommendations in the real world. Don't go through an affiliate. Don't go to someone who says, wow, he changed my life. There are many people who get paid money to give you bullshit. So be careful of that. So I only go through people who can show me the actual work that they have done, and then I take them. It's always best to go to a company that has a reputation. If you're going through a freelancer, check his credentials, check his work, check what he has done online. Don't check any of his marketing material, don't check his website, because that is where they brag. See what content they keep giving you out. And if you can relate to this content, and you know them for months and months and years, then go for them. The next point is, point number 16, is the importance of keeping things in order. And I think I learned this through visiting, Toyota. If you go to any Toyota company or any Japanese company or Honda, you'll notice every tool is kept in a place. Everything is kept in a place. Everything is kept in order. There's not a screwdriver out of place. There's not a screw out of place. You know, the reason why they do this is because it helps in productivity. So I have adopted the same strategy with my work. Everything is kept in place. Batteries, one place. Smart devices, one place. Wires and cabling, one place. If you keep things like this in order, like food items in one place, noodles in one place, cold drinks in one place, everything, you stack it up properly, it'll really help you. And the benefit of this is you don't have to figure out where you have kept what. Even when you keep clothes in your wardrobe, in your hanger, like for me, banyans in one place and kept in one way, and same design, it's not the hanger is this way, the other one is this way, and there's a black shirt here and red shirt here. No, all my white shirts kept in one way. Then all the, and for me, you know, I follow the Steve Jobs style. All same color shirts, same color trousers, same color everything. So it helps me. Yes, there are two or three shirts that I use for my presentation on video, which are different. Otherwise, white banyans, dark trousers, and black shirts, all same. They have kept in the same way. So I can remove this way and keep in this way. So keep things in order, very, very important. All the spices in one place, all the, you know, bathroom accessories and whatever. Point number 17, this might be a bit controversial. Everything that is excess, throw it out. For me, after I started sorting out the mess in my house, I found so many things my wife had kept that we'll use it one day. I'll give you an example. Like, she bought papers, pens, keychains, mugs, giveaway items. I had enough of this. I looked at all this, just storing and collecting dust. Took it all out and I gave it off. I gave to whomsoever, take it for free, gave it to some poor people. And when things are empty and nothing was there in the house, there's so much of peace and calm. So don't keep collecting stuff, sort things out. And I'll tell you, that really help you. So just throw, I'll tell you, get rid of stuff, it'll improve your productivity, it'll help you think clearly. When there is less stuff on your desk, more work gets done, you know. Point number 18, which is, if you know me, you know this, cleanliness. Watch the documentary Ants on a Shrimp. I don't want to repeat that same thing, but you should clean your table, your kitchen, your living room so well. You can literally, like, you know, you should be able to almost like lick it and it's that clean. Don't do that. But, you know, when I clean, even the kitchen or whatever, it's not only with Dettol, it's not only with bleach, it's not only with soap. After cleaning everything, I dry it and I look at it and there shouldn't be a single spot. It should be that clean. And I'll tell you, if you keep your stuff, your work environment, your kitchen spotless, like a 5-star hotel, I'll tell you, it'll just improve your productivity. The best example is, go to an Apple store. See how clean it is. From their design to everything else. From their website to their workstation. Perfect. Point number 19. Upgrading. It can be very frustrating when you have a slow PC or when you have a slow machine. So it's necessary sometimes to upgrade. For me, when I was sorting out, I looked at, okay, this brush is old. Why are we keeping it? This spray is old. Why are we keeping it? This tap is old. It's not putting water properly. I literally spend money for upgrades on all this. Why? Because when things are working fast, when they are working to their full potential, much better. I replaced the fridge. I got rid of the microwave oven. The kettle was old. The toaster was not up to the mark. I'll tell you, you'll feel much better if you get new stuff. So don't just go crazy, but stuff that you use every day, upgrade it. Like a very simple thing, instead of buying cheap coffee, why don't you buy the best refined coffee if you're having that every day? For example, your shoes. If you're using shoes every day for running, or get the best. Like before, I had ordinary slippers, which look like Crocs, but they are not original Crocs. I went and purchased the best Crocs that came out in the market, but it should feel good. It should, you know, be useful. It should be like stuff that I can relate to every day. So whether it's your coffee, whether it's your slippers, whether it's your exercise outfit, make sure it's upgraded to the best of what you can use. Point number 20 is support. Without your family support, without the support of a circle of friends who believe in you, you cannot succeed. I don't know how much to emphasize this. See, let's say for example, you want to lose weight, but your friends are hogging and eating food. You will not lose weight. You want to quit smoking and everyone else is smoking. How will you quit the habit? Or let's say for instance, I want to do work. I want to be productive. Obviously, my wife is not into my line of work, but at least she should support by making sure there's no noise. The baby is not troubling me. Things are kept in order. Food is served to me on time. You know, like, otherwise you cannot function here. So make sure that your family is supportive. Now, I know the question is, Loy, what if my family is not supportive? Then you need to leave your family. Why do you think I broke off with all my family members? Why do you think I left all my friends? Because they were driving me fucking crazy, man. They were not going to help me achieve my goals and my dreams. So you need to make a tough choice. What is more important to you? For me, my dreams, my productivity, my work is very important. That's why even my wife, I've told her, if you come in between me and my work and I'm not able to function and perform, it's better you're not there in my life. It's as simple as that. And I'm not apologetic about it. Make sure that the people who are there in your life help you with productivity. And last, if not the least, point number 21. Get rid of the assholes. You know, toxic people, people who are toxic, you need to tell them to get the fuck out of your life, man. Because these people can really mess up your fucking head. They can mess up your system. They can mess up your thought process. They'll just fuck up things. It can be your relative. It can be your girlfriend. It can be your boyfriend. It can be whomsoever. If you have to get rid of an asshole, whether it's your boss, whether it's your colleague, literally, just imagine you're working for a company and your boss is toxic or your colleagues are gossipy or your work environment is not good. How can you perform? So for me, when I'm dealing with people, if I find someone as a liability, I choose not to work with that person. So it's very important to get rid of toxic people. It's very important to get rid of negative people or, let's say, assholes. So make sure that they're kept far away from your life. So yeah, these were the 21 points that I wanted to give you in terms of productivity, in terms of what has helped me succeed. I don't know how much of it you can relate to or what you'll use, but this is the best of what I can give you that will help you succeed in your life. So see what you want to use, apply these principles, and let me know out of what I've shared with you, which one you'll use in your life, which one you'll adopt, which one you have actually done. And if you have any experience, feel free to share because I read your comments. So having said that, this is me sharing my thought process. Let me know what you think. I think someone has come near my house, so I'll keep you updated. All right, you guys take care. This is me signing off. Bye.
Yeah, yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.